Hello students, today I am going to discuss the topic data transmission and telemetry. Okay, under module 4, I will overview on the syllabus. Module 4, the data transmission and telemetry, and next bit is the measurement of non-electrical quantities, pressure measurement. Okay. So under that, today I am going to discuss about the data or signal transmission. Okay. So here, as per the syllabus, the sequence of the presentation is as follows: mechanical transmission, hydraulic transmission, pneumatic transmission, and magnetic transmission. Okay. Finally, electric type of transmitter converters. Okay. So this is the syllabus is given under data bar signal transmission. Okay, let us first define the term data transmission, okay, and telemetry. Okay. So this two refers to the process by which the measurement is transferred to a remote location for the purpose of being processed, recorded, and displayed. So here, the transmitter as a it is a device which transmits the value of primary variable at a considerable distance from the primary element, okay, where it is sensed and it will be transmitted. Okay, the value of primary variable at a considerable distance from the primary element. Okay, if transmission is to be carried over a very long distance, then devices are known as telemetries. Okay. For data transmission, various methods have been developed. The choice of particular methods depends upon the physical variable, what it is sent, and the distance involved. Right? So here, the hydraulic and pneumatic methods are employed for transmission over a short distance. I repeat here, the hydraulic and pneumatic methods are employed for transmission over a short distance. Okay, whereas electrical and electronics methods are suitable equally for short as well as long distance transmission. Okay. Now, today, as I told, I am going to discuss about these transmissions. First one is mechanical transmission, hydraulic transmission, pneumatic transmission, and magnetic transmission. So here, the first one is the mechanical transmission. The rack and pinion arrangement and the gear trains are used to transmit the as a transmitter it is used. Okay, burden tube also it will be used. Earlier also I discussed the burden tube. Okay, when it will be liquid, it will be flows under some pressure, then the pivoted pointer it will be moves over the graduated scale. Okay, so these amplify the displacement and also transmit the signal to a pointer which moves across a calibrated die. Okay, so these are the few figures I put here. Okay, first one is rack and pinion arrangement, second one is trains of gear, and third one is burden tube. Next one is the hydraulic transmission. So here the figure shows here the hydraulic method of transmission, which is commonly used. Here, four bellows are employed. Okay, two at the transmission end and two at the receiving end. I repeat here. Just I will show. So, one and two at transmitting end, and these are in the receiving end. Okay. The four bellows are connected by an impulse pipeline, okay, and the whole system is filled with liquid. Okay, that's operating. When the activating link on the transmission end is operated by the measurement, okay, here it is operated by the measurement, then one bellow is expanded and other is compressed. Okay, one is expands and the other one is contracted means it will be compressed. So suppose if it is one is compressed, other one is be expands. So this expansion and contraction is communicated to receiving end. So this it will be communicated to the receiving end. So what it will be happens, which moves the receiving pointer in an equal amount. Okay, so this is the briefly I have explained about the hydraulic method. Okay, depending upon the bellows compression and expand, okay, that it will be communicated to the receiving end and pointer will be indicates. Okay, and here the purpose of using two bellows on either side is compensate for changes in ambient temperature. Next one is the pneumatic transmission. So here nozzle and flapper mechanism is displacement type detector, which converts mechanical moment into a pressure signal. So here so here let us first we'll discuss the construction. It consists of any open nozzle which is supplied with air. Okay, so this is the open nozzle. Here we are supplying with air. Okay, so the here the restriction, the diameter, it's a diameter being small, then the nozzle diameter, this is there maintaining here. Okay, the diameter of this one will be small as compared to the nozzle diameter. Okay, for proper functioning. Okay, so in front of the nozzle there is a flapper. This is a flapper. Okay, so here in front of the nozzle there is a flapper which is positioned by measuring element. The force on the flapper is produced by a transducer which converts the measurement into linear displacement. Okay, so here the flapper movement it will be sensed. Okay, so how much it is there. So here the amplifier is there. Okay, the working let us I will explain here. When the flapper is moved against the nozzle, it means it will be moved in this direction. Okay, so in this direction, let us once I will clear. So now the working, when the flapper is move against the nozzle, so it's nothing but we are moving this linear due to this linear movement transduced from the measurement. So here it will be gives the movement here in this direction. Okay, the air cannot escape and maximum air is passes to the amplifier. So what it will be happens, it will be blocking this nozzle nearer to it will become we can't say that it will be blocking, so that it will becomes to the nearer. Okay, so that what it will be happens, the when the flapper is moved towards the nozzle, the maximum air passes to the amplifier. Here it will be passes because you are supplying the air from here and the maximum it will be passes to the here, maximum air it will be passes. When flapper is moved away from the nozzle, so if it is moved away from the nozzle, so minimum air passes to the amplifier. Okay, as most of the air escapes to the atmosphere, what it will be happens here, atmosphere it will be escapes because flapper is away from the this one, away from the nozzle. Thus the movement of flapper from one extreme position to another serves to control the amplifier, which produces an air pressure proportional to the measurement of adequate strength for transmission over the required distance. Okay, depending upon the how much pressure it will be developed, that it will be sensed here the amplifier. Okay, so this is the basic schematic of the circuit, shows the schematic of the pneumatic transmission flapper nozzle mechanism. this is the plot of signal pressure versus gap. Okay, for your understanding purpose, I put one graph here. So it is approximately linear. Okay, the plot of signal pressure versus gap. Okay, so here we can see that the output pressure and the gap, it will be linearized. So next one is the pneumatic transmission, and these are the explanation. Okay, next one is the magnetic transmission. So here shows the schematic of magnetic transmission. In this arrangement, any armature is attached. Here the armature is attached. Okay, armature is attached at the end of the mechanical moving part, whose movement is to be transmitted. I repeat here, the mechanical movement here. Okay, the mechanical movement, I will clear. Okay, the mechanical movement is to be transmitted outside the armature, moving inside a non-magnetic tube. Okay, so here the mechanical moving parts whose movement is here measuring. Okay, so the what it is there here, armature moving inside a non-magnetic tube. A magnet is placed around the armature outside the tube. Okay, a magnet is this is a magnet. Okay, this is a magnet is placed around the armature outside the tube. The magnet follows the movement of the armature. What it will be happens here, when the mechanical movement it will be come to the this mechanical movement, it will be comes from the transducer. Okay, that it will be moves, and the magnet is placed around the armature outside the tube. Hence the magnet follows the movement of the armature and reposition a pneumatic transmitter. Okay, the magnet movement could also be utilized to operate an electronic transmitter. Okay, so this is the basic principle of the magnetic transmission. Why it is called magnetic means here the magnet is used. Okay, so that magnet will be follows the movement of the armature. I repeat here, the magnet follows the movement of the armature and repositions a pneumatic transmitter. Okay, so here the electronic type of transmitters, most of the electric type of transmitters employs AC bridges. Okay, circuits in which degree of coupling between inductance is varied. Okay, so the most of the AC bridges they are using, and the inductance varied by changing the amount of iron core within a coil. So these are the examples. It is given here: Wheatstone bridge transmitter, inductance bridge, impedance bridge, differential transformer, self-synchronous motor, and resistance manometer. So we are not going through this all the transmitters, only in syllabus what it is given so far, what I discuss only that much. And finally the converters here, the most commonly used as current to pneumatic converters, pneumatic to current, and voltage to current, and voltage to pneumatic converters. Okay, here also we are not going in the details about this converters and the electric type transmitters. We are not going in detail. Okay, so next class I will start with the telemetry. Okay, so I conclude. Before concluding, just little we have to worry on the today's this one class. Just I will go to the first slide. Okay, so here today I have discussed about this mechanical transmission, okay, hydraulic transmission, pneumatic transmission, magnetic transmission, okay, and finally electric type of transmitter and converters. Okay, thank you. With this, I conclude this session.